tonight on TBS. John Wayne and Ann Margaret. The combination is pure gold.
Gold? $500,000 worth.
The Train Robbers, 10:35 Eastern tonight on TBS. The following is a presentation of TBS Sports.
Don't ask for help, you're all alone.
Pressure!
You'll have to answer to your own.
Pressure!
I'm sure you have some cosmic rationale.
Into the wall. He caught it! Unbelievable!
Kiss this one goodbye. It's a slam. And down the stretch he comes. Here's it! Braves win! Braves win! Braves win! Braves win! Braves win!
Hello again, everybody. Along with Don Sutton, Skip Carey, welcoming you to another night of Atlanta Braves baseball, and a big night it is as the Braves and the Giants meet in the first game of a three-game series, the final three games of the year between the two teams. Bill Swift will be on the mound against Greg Maddux, two fine right-handed pitchers. Braves had great luck against Bill, however, out in San Francisco a week ago, Don.
Well, I think there are three things we should think about tonight, Skip. Number one has to do with Bill Swift. He told us out there, I'm a pitcher that's going to throw strikes on the first pitch. If his pitches are moving, then the Braves are not going to get a whole lot to hit. On the other hand, if he's uptight, tense, and they're straight, the Braves are going to get some first pitch pitches to hit. Second thing, we got to compare the third, fourth, and fifth batters in the middle of their order and in ours. Both teams rely on production from there. See what happens last week. And one guy who has specifically struggled against the Braves in spotlight situations, postseason play in 91, 92, and then last week is Barry Bonds. He has something like 13 out of 61, only three RBIs. I think the most important at bat of the night will be Bonds' first one against Maddux. And oh yeah, the third thing, when these three are over, we should think about the 28 others that have to be played.
That's right. That's an important item, too. There's a month to play when these three games come to a close. There's been a lot of talking in Atlanta for the last 48 hours. The talking is about over. It's time to start playing. And we'll be back with the starting lineups, then the play-by-play story right after this.
The Braves will have 30 more games after this one tonight, but the only one these folks are interested in, it is electric here, is this game tonight. So let's get right to the Napa Auto Parts starting lineups. For the visiting Giants, 85 and 45, it's going to be Dave Martinez leading it off. Robbie Thompson, he's on a tear, he'll bat second. Willie McGee moves into the third spot. Matt Williams will bat cleanup. Barry Bonds back in the fifth spot. Todd Benzinger, he's been hot lately. He had a good trip down to Miami. He'll hit sixth. Seventh is Royce Clayton. Man wearing the eighth hitter, and Bill Swift will pitch in bat ninth. Defensively, the Braves will line up with Gann in left, Nixon in center, Justice in right, Pendleton third, Blauser short, Lemke at second, McGriff is over at first, Damon Berryhill behind the plate, and Greg Maddux on the mound. You see his numbers right there. Maddux is as good as it gets. Thought to be by many the best, most complete pitcher in the National League. And I'll tell you what, the second half of the season, you could not want anybody else any better. 20 games over 500 when it gets to crunch time. Here are the umpires for kickoff of this series. It's going to be Frank Pulley calling the balls and strikes. It'll get over quick. Joe West, Gary Darling, and Charlie Williams completed. We're all set to go, and so is Skip Carey.
Okay, Don, thanks very much. Dave Martinez hitting 239 for the year. In his career, just 7 out of 51 against Maddux. We're underway. Base hit left center field. Gant over fast to try to cut it off. He can't. Nixon does. Martinez stays at first base. So the Giants with a message of their own, a solid single to start the game by Martinez. Robbie Thompson the batter, and he's a red-hot hitter. He's hit in 21 of his last 23 games, and he leads the Giants in hitting at 341. Thompson hasn't had much luck against Maddux either. 7 out of 34. He's from West Palm Beach. Dodgers made some news today. They traded outfielder Eric Davis to Detroit for a player to be named later. Martinez with just 6 stolen bases and 8 tries. On the corner, 0-1. Runner at first, nobody out. We're just underway in Atlanta.
Thompson is a better hitter when he gets pitches to pull. I think Maddux kind of showed us right there what he has in mind. Going to try to get him something on the outside corner. If he shows him a pitch inside, it'll be just a showcase pitch.
Again, Barry Hill sets up outside. And that's where the pitch is. A ball and a strike, the count. The crowd roared as if that was a strike, but I'm pretty sure Frank Pulley called it a ball.
Not even in the American League was that one a strike.
1-1, the count. Just missed that time. 2-1. Everything has been away, as Don suggested. 2 balls, 1 strike.
Well, if a guy's hot out there, you may get him to pull the ball and get a double play out of him. But if a guy's hot like Thompson, and he's been hitting home runs from pitches inside, if you do nothing else, you want to make him an adjustment.
The 2-1 pitch, Martinez Ali. This is a pretty good hit-and-run pitch if that's the way the Giants choose to play it. You saw Wendell Kim running through the signs at third base. Bobby Bonds coaches at first, and there's the manager, Dusty Baker, the former Braves outfield.
And this is one time when Thompson will make an adjustment. If you give him the situation where you got the second base covering, he will take a shot to the right side.
Let's see if they send the runner 2-1. No. High pop. That's going to reach the seats, and the count evens at 2-2. John Smoltz probably against Brian Hickerson tomorrow night, and then Steve Avery and John Burkett in the final game of the series on Thursday. Don't forget, the Padres come in thereafter, and as Don said, 28 games remain when this series comes to a close. It's very important, but it's not the end of the year. Runner goes this time, chopped up the middle. Lemke has only one play to first in time. And had the runner not been going, that ball probably gets into center field. Runner in scoring position, one out. Here's Willie McGee, who, since coming off the disabled list 25 games ago, is hitting just 245, but for the year, he's hitting 317. He was a very over-anxious hitter out in San Francisco, wasn't he, Doc?
Yes, he was. He was jumping at the first pitch, and once, well, Maddux has tied him up. Once he got that first strike, he didn't wait for anything else close to the plate, and he was really jumping at off-speed pitches down. A couple that bounced up there he hacked at.
He's having a great year. Took a shot at left field, fouled it away 0-1. His old Cardinal partner, Terry Pendleton, at third for Atlanta, of course. 0-1 the count. Phillies hammered the Cubs today, 7-0 the final score. Into the dirt, Barry held a good play, and the count evens up, 1-1. Runner at second, 1 down. Boy, it is a World Series atmosphere here. The press box is overflowing. A ball and a strike. Martinez runs well. He's at second. Just missed the inside corner. Down and in. It's 2-1.
what he's trying to do with McGee. He got the fastball strike in. He tried to get him to chase a changeup. He wouldn't. Then he tried to cut a fastball or run a little slider in on his hands, but McGee not biting on that one. See if Maddux comes back with a changeup. He normally does that after setting up something inside.
He did, and he had him off stride and fouled it off. 2-2. Don Sutton, Skip Carey with you from Atlanta Fulton County Stadium. I assume you know by now, but the Giants lead by 4.5, 5 on the loss side coming into the game. And a 2-2 to McGee. Strike three call, fastball at the knee. McGee knew it, 2 out.
Take those 5 pitches right there and you got a videotape on pitching. Fastball coming into him, he fouled off. Change up away, slider coming into him, change up away. Fastball that he started inside, ran it back over the inside corner. If you can't learn a lesson watching Greg Maddux pitch, you can't learn a lesson.
I was thinking yesterday, I wonder how much of Avery's marked improvement has been just by observing the way Maddux pitches.
There are a lot of people who say Guzman and Morgan would be better at Chicago if they had Maddux there to work with them.
High pop right side. Justice, a long run. McGriff and Lemke out there, too. It'll be McGriff, and he can't make the play. With his back to the infield, he couldn't make it. He'd have been better off perhaps trying to scoop that ball rather than...
He might have been better off giving way or having Lemke or Justice call him off of that. He had the toughest angle of the three. And you'll see right here, both Lemke and Justice, close enough they could have made the play. There's Lemke. He just pulls up. But I have a feeling Fred was calling for it the whole way. But that's the toughest angle in the park.
No error will be charged. But Matt Williams gets a swing on the house here. 0-1 the count. Williams hitting 296, 27 homers, 84 RBIs, 8 out of 25. He's done well against Maddux in his career, a home run included. Owen won the count. High pop foul back, and Maddux now is 0-2. He likes to finish hitters off. He doesn't like to mess around with them. Let's see what he does on the 0-2 pitch. Barry Bonds is next.
He got a break there, too. He got Matt Williams to swing at a setup pitch. That wasn't a pitch he was trying to get a strike on. It was a pitch he was trying to run inside to set up what he wanted to do next.
0-2 the count.
So Williams got a free swing. Maddux got a break on the next pitch. It's all even now.
There are two out. Martinez at second. He went right after him. Just missed. A ball and two strikes. If you get Williams, you accomplish two things. You get the inning over with, and you get Bonds up there leading off an inning where the worst he can do is cost you a run. You can see how effective he is when he gets ahead in the count. Should be easy and in. One hit, no runs, no errors, one left. Bottom of the first. Giants, nothing. Braves come to bat.
Sunday night NFL on TNT. It's opening night, and Wieren Moon has a lot on his mind, like the Saints' defense. Regular season kicks off with the Oilers and Saints Sunday night at 8 Eastern on TNT.
James Earl Jones, Billy D. Williams, and Courtney B. Vance as Thunder, a fighter in a split decision between honor and corruption. Percy and Thunder from TNT Screenworks premieres September 7th.
Another talent being displayed here at the stadium for which there is little or no use. Giants fail to score. Braves coming up. Here's the batting order. Nixon, Blauser, and Ganter, the first three. McGriff will hit cleanup. He'll be followed by David Justice and Terry Pendleton. Final three in the batting order, Damon Berryhill, Mark Lemke, and Greg Maddux. The Giants defensively
We'll show an outfield of Bonds in left, Martinez in center, and McGee in right. The infield, Williams, Clayton, Thompson and Benziger, Kirk Manwaring, and gets the start behind the plate. And Bill Swift on the mound. There you see Swift and his numbers. Very good numbers. He is up there in areas as far as innings pitched that he hadn't been before. That's something to watch the next month of the season. Likes to throw a strike on the first pitch. If it's moving, he gets the out. Unfortunately for a lot of the hitters, it hadn't been moving. Remember last week over in San Francisco, Braves hammered him on the first pitch in the first inning.
Otis Nixon leads it off for Atlanta. Inside, knocked him off the plate. One ball, no strikes. Braves have won 16 out of 19. They're 31-11 since the All-Star break. The best record in baseball. Missed down and in again, 2-0. The good news is he's missing. The bad news for Braves fans is both those pitches were down where he likes to operate. Missed inside every time.
See, he knew out there that nothing was moving and he kept throwing strikes, and I'll bet you what he's here doing here is he's so conscious and making so much of an effort to try to get movement that he's giving up control.
There's a strike at the letters, 3-1. Otis hitting 252. He's 21 of his last 56. He picked a perfect time to get hot with Deion Sanders disabled. He didn't get that one, and a full count is the result. Three balls, two strikes. No empty seats around the old ball yard tonight, or at least very few of them. A payoff to Nixon. Struck him out. They'll have to throw him out, and Manwaring does, and a pretty good comeback for Swift. He was behind 3-0. One away. Jeff Blauser, the hitter, he's been red hot. 23 out of his last 43.
Severe movement on this sinker. Starts it above the knees. Watch how much it moves. Nixon is right on it, so that's almost to the plate.
Blauser hitting 312, 14 homers, 55 runs driven in. Ran up to bunt, took a strike, and popped away from Manwaring, 0-1. Ron Gant is on deck. Remember, against Swift out there, it was McGriff and Justice back-to-back a couple of times. 0-2. So Swift quickly out in front. There's been some talk about him being on a pitch count, but that's all nonsense. Fastball up and in, and he's a different looking pitcher in the early going. 1-2. He normally doesn't use many pitches to get through a game, but there is no set number for him. Two balls, two strikes.
I don't know what you think about that, but I think having a pitch count isn't really fair, because every game that you pitch, the circumstances are different. The effort you put into pitching, the hitters you face. So to have one pitch count that you stick to really doesn't make any sense.
I'll be darned. He was ahead 0-2 and ran it 3-2. For the first hitter, he was 3-0 and came back to get a strikeout. So let's see what happens here. Just missed the outside corner. Frank Pulley started to ring him up. Swift thought he had a strikeout.
Well, let's see how close to the corner it comes. Much like Maddux, he likes to start it off and move it back over. If Manwaring had done a little bit better job of handling that, bringing it back toward the strike zone, he might have got the call.
Here's Ron Gant hitting at 268 in his last 20 games, 21 RBI. McGriff moves on deck. So each team a first inning base runner. Again, he just missed. One ball, no strikes. Gant takes a look at Jimmy Williams. He's the third base coach. As you know, Pat Corrales the first. Blauser, 14 out of 19. You wouldn't figure him to be running with the Bombers coming up here for the first run of bat. In his career, Gant has hit 19 homers and driven home 64 runs against the Giants. Okay,
Double play ball, maybe. Out there. Out there. 6-4-3. Clayton turns it over, and the Braves go quietly in the first, as did the Giants. No hits, no runs, no errors. Nobody left. At the end of an inning, no score. Barry Bonds leads off the second. He's driven in 100 runs for the fourth straight year. And he taps this one weakly down the first baseline, but unfortunately foul, 0-1. Bonds at 338, 38 homers, 100 RBI. He hit the daylights out of the ball against the Braves early in the year. Was held pretty well in check over in San Francisco a week or so ago. The 0-1. Line drive, center field. Nixon comes on, but it falls for a hit. So the leadoff man is on for the second straight inning. And here's Todd Benzinger. He's in there for Will Clark. And Clark's a terrific player, but Benzinger has been a tremendous help in his absence. In his last 17 games, he's hitting .404, and he's hitting .302 on the year, and he's a switcher.
I think that's a big hit for Bonds in the scheme of things. He's a pretty emotional guy. He's been feeling some pretty good strain. I believe he'll be more relaxed. He's going to be a tougher out the rest of the way.
He edges away. He's got 20 stolen bases, too, and Maddux knows it and chases him back. Benzinger, Clayton, and Manwaring, the next three up there for the Giants. There goes the runner. High throw. High. Safe. Lemke backs up. Bonds has his 21st stolen base in 30 attempts.
Not a good throw by Damon Berryhill, and a good jump by Bonds. Look, he's off and running about five steps. The throw way up and away, and a good job right there of Mark Lemke. But not just standing around, but being there, because Bonds would have made it to third easily if Lemke's not there.
Runner at second, nobody out. Benzinger waits. You better keep an eye on Bonds at second base, too. There's a strike right in there. 1-1, the count to Benzinger. Came up in the Red Sox organization. Wound up with the Reds in his hometown, Cincinnati, then with the Dodgers, and now the Giants.
And that's probably one of those deals, Skip, a lot of people look at and you say, well, you got Will Clark there. All he's going to be is a glove carrier for the year. But you never know when a situation like this comes around, and he had a good series down in Miami.
Pop foul. Pendleton has no chance. It's in the seats. It's 1-2. And Benzinger, one of those guys, I would think, who's in a financial bracket where his services are appealing. He's not a $4 or $5 million a year guy. He's a switch hitter, can play a little outfield without embarrassing you. A very good first baseman.
A veteran who has been on a winner before. Bob Quinn said that those were the kind of guys he was looking for to complement his ball club.
Bonds jockeying with Maddux. Now Benzinger steps out. But Bonds is trying to bother Maddux, and he may succeed, but then again, it may be Benzinger that he bothers. Pull the ball to get the runner to third, but hit it foul. Count goes to 1-2. The Braves never trailed the Giants in the series in San Francisco, and they tied nothing after one in this game. A ball and two strikes. Ground ball, sharply hit. McGriff has it. Runner to third. That's a good job of hitting by Benzinger, despite the fact that he's retired, and he hit the ball hard, and he gives Royce Clayton a chance to drive in a run. But Clayton has really struggled. He's hitting .217 in his last 129 at-bats, has just 28 hits. And has struck out a good bit, and that's what Maddux would like to have here. Berryhill to the mound for a word with Maddux.
I think if you ask Greg Maddux, he'd probably like to have the infield back here and maybe trade the run for an out, but he's probably a situation he's not going to get the vote on. But Clayton is a candidate to strike out.
I have known pitchers who in this situation would
call a meeting.
Either that or the pitch. Little squibber back to the mound. That'll do nothing. Throw to first in time. Clayton failed. And you've got the number eight hitter up there, Kurt Manwaring. Giants have missed chances time and time again in these last four games against Atlanta.
See, that's knowing your hitter. He knows Clayton likes to jump on that first pitch, so he gave him a pitch that started out a strike. But with his movement, he can do that. He can throw strikes that end up not being strikes and still get hitters to swing at him.
I started to say, I've known of pitchers who would
I know what you started
unintentionally or intentionally unintentionally walk the hitters so but, they'd get the infield back. Didn't you?
Not in our lifetime have we.
You know, once in the Astrodome it happened.
Your memory's getting better, unfortunately.
Pitch to Manwaring. It's high, one ball, no strikes. So Bill Verdon, if you're watching, the truth is now out. One ball, no strikes. A good hitting pitcher would be next. There's a strike on the corner. Manwaring, 3 out of 9 in his career against Maddux. He's hitting .278 on the year. White Sox have jumped on the Yankees. They lead them 2-0 after one in the stadium. Hit. Fastball up and in. So the pitcher, Swift, will hit with runners on the corner. No, he was not throwing at him, folks.
He was just trying to get him to do the same thing Clayton did. Chase a running fastball in on, try to jam him, and it ran too far. That's one of those where Manwaring probably should have tried a little harder to get out of the way. You'd much rather have him hitting than to go to the pitcher, although Swift is a good hitter.
Yeah, he's hitting .267, but with just 3 RBIs, as you see.
I think the point you made one night in a situation like this is a very good one. When you've got the pitcher coming up, you've got a runner in scoring position, that eighth place hitter has got to expand his strike zone. You've got to look for something to hit, maybe out of an area where you would normally want it.
Swift takes a strike. The Braves play him way around toward right. If he hits the ball down the left field line, 2 runs might score. That's how far over Gant is. You see the alignment of the Atlanta outfield. They don't figure him to pull Greg Maddux. First and third, 2 out. Should be out of the inning. Lemke fields. Lemke throws. Inning over. One hit, no runs, no errors, 2 left. Bottom half of the second inning. Still no score in the ball game.
Terrorists have stolen the ultimate weapon. It's an impossible mission for America's top secret agents.
Darling, the oysters come with guns. Excuse me.
Next time, buy American.
Undercover Blues. Every marriage needs a little excitement.
Kill the light.
Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, September 10th at theaters everywhere.
Playoff-type ambiance at the ballpark tonight. This telecast is authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the Atlanta National League Baseball Club and is intended solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, retransmission, or the use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the express written consent of the Atlanta National League Baseball Club will get you in trouble with that man right there. It's prohibited.
Yeah, you saw Ted Turner, Jane Fonda, and behind them was one of my favorite people, Ruby Lucas, the widow of the former Braves General manager Bill Lucas. He is a terrific fellow. All of us who knew him still miss him. Fred McGriff leads off the bottom half of the second inning. He's had good luck against Swift in his career. He takes a strike there, 0-1. 9 out of 23 against him with 3 home runs. Every nook and cranny of this ballpark is filled with folks tonight.
That's a ball.
A little bit outside. And it's 1-1. The outfield plays McGriff just about straight away and very deep. The Giants have left 3 men aboard in the first 2 innings. Right back where it came from. An easy play for Swift. And swiftly, McGriff is retired and David Justice the batter.
See, that's the identical pitch he tried to throw McGriff out there that got drilled into the night. He wanted it out away from him, but now instead of getting no movement or flat movement, he's getting the sink that he wanted out there.
David Justice is the batter. 7 of his last 21 and 5 of them have been homers. A good cut, but he fouled it back. It's nothing and one. No score, bottom of the second. Don Sutton, Skip Carey with you. Pete Van Wieren, Joe Simpson will join you after 4.5.
That's a ball
and a strike. One out, nobody aboard. Terry Pendleton is next. Line deep right field. Back goes McGee. He's got it. It was hit hard, but out. That's the first ball they've gotten in the air. Terry Pendleton stands in there. Terry hitting 271, 10 homers, 59 RBI. He's hitting 341 against Giant pitching this year, and he takes a strike. It's 0-1. Mets lead Houston 2-0 after 2. Houston's lost 5 in a row again. They're a funny team. 1-1 the count. Terry waits with that wide open stance. The pitch moves him off the plate. 2 balls, 1 strike. Two out, nobody aboard. Up the middle, Clayton to his left, gloves it and throws him out from the second base side of the bag. 1-2-3, nothing doing. A distressing number of ground balls early from Swift. At the end of 2, no score. Next on TBS, that means following the game, Ann Margaret plays an outlaw's widow who hires John Wayne and his associates to find her husband's hidden gold. The Train Robbers, next on TBS.
You get to do all the good promos.
I don't know why they didn't let you do it. I would be upset were I you. Dave Martinez leads off the third.
I get to do the Cheyenne Social Club.
The pitch. Inside, 1 ball, no strikes. That pitch came just in time. Nobody on, nobody out. Third inning. Martinez hit one hard and into left center his first time. Upstairs, 2-0. Leadoff man has been on in both innings for the Giants, but they have nothing to show for it. They had a runner at third. One out, first and third, 2 out, and the second and failed to score. and had a runner at second with one out in the first and came up empty, which was exactly the way they played in Atlanta. There's a strike on the corner, 2-1. Giants pitching in the last few weeks has gone from second in the league to fifth. But that kid Salomon Torres and last night Sanderson really gave him a shot in the arm. 2-2 to Martinez.
And when you win, unless you're blessed with a Braves type pitching staff, and few are, you get a shot in the arm sometime during the season from a guy like Torres and from a guy like Sanderson.
The 2-2 to the leadoff man will not be made. Martinez steps up. We don't see the American League teams much, but I've got to believe that right now at this moment the Atlanta Braves are the best team in baseball. That doesn't mean they're going to win their division or the LCS or the World Series, but right now with that pitching and with the offense they're getting and the good defense they've had all year, I can't see anybody being any better.
Well, don't you think when pitching is good, the offense is going to get better because there's less pressure on it? And I think it's just the opposite is true too. When there's consistent offense, then the pitchers don't feel the pressure. That's why this ball club is fun to watch, because it's such a blend of people who can put points on the board and people who can keep it off.
Full count, 3-2. The Giants, on the other hand, the way their pitching has gone lately, you have to fight from thinking we got to score 7-8 runs tonight. You just got to go out and play. Easy to say, hard to do. Payoff pitch to Martinez. Just missed the outside corner. So for the third inning in a row, the leadoff man is on. First walk of the game for Maddux. Robbie Thompson, the batter, they played hit and run with him the first time. He grounded out. Let's see if they do it again.
A lot of people pitching, and you know, who knows, maybe the Giants will get to him in a situation like this, but a lot of pitchers, you would worry about this. But Maddux has two ways to combat it. Number one, he is definitely a strikeout pitcher. And number two, he gets ground balls, which turn into double plays.
He chases the runner back. Houston has claimed the lead over the Mets 3-2 at Shea Stadium tonight. San Diego and Florida scoreless after 3.5. Hit and run. Fouled it off. Martinez was going on the pitch. Thompson fouled it away. It's 0-1. So Dusty Baker, very aggressive early in this game. He's played hit and run twice. He's had Bond steal a base, trying to get his team on the board. I know they'd like to get the lead one time, and the Braves would like to prevent that.
Well, they're 63-15 when they score first.
0-1 the count. Thompson with 17 homers, 59 RBIs. High fly ball, pretty well hit in the center, but it's playable. In right center, it's Justice who makes the play. One down. So Thompson is 0-2. Here's Willie McGee, a strikeout victim, his first time. McGee, a lot of people have forgotten, came up in the Yankee organization. One of the worst deals New York's ever made was unloading this guy. He's been a quality player for more than a decade.
For a left-handed pitcher named Bob Sykes that didn't last very long.
McGee waits. Martinez edges away. Will he be running? Maddux thinks maybe so and chases him back. Pitch out, nothing happening. 1-0, and that pitch out makes a hit and run more likely on subsequent pitches. Wendell Kim runs through the signs. Yeah. Little tap down the first baseline. McGriff has only one play to make. Runner in scoring position again, but again, two are out. And Matt Williams is the batter. Every out retired except for one has been a ground ball or a strikeout. Thompson's fly ball to right field just a moment ago, the only one that's been in the air.
He's done some clutch hitting with his home runs. 18 out of his 27 home runs, Skip, have either, there you are, tied or have given the Giants the lead.
And he's an outstanding defensive third baseman with a strong arm. Didn't embarrass himself as a shortstop.
No, that's what most people forget. As big as he still has a lot of speed, a lot of agility, and was a good shortstop.
Bonds would be next. They're two out in the inning. Low and away. One ball, no strikes.
Speaking of big guys playing shortstop, a banner year for Chipper Jones down at AAA.
Hit something like 330 to this point.
Walked about 60 times, only struck out about 60 times.
Drove in a bunch of runs, too. Ground ball down the third baseline is foul. Pendleton had him played wide of the bag. They'd have never thrown him out had Terry gotten to the ball, but it was foul. And the count evens. His first time up, Williams grounded to first. This time he tried to pull the ball. The guessing game between hitter and pitcher goes on. You see, the Giants have had their chances early. It's games like this are really the reason that Greg Maddux signed with the Atlanta Braves.
Two sides of that coin. He wanted to be in games like this that were in a pennant race, and the Braves wanted somebody like him out there.
Looper into right center field. Justice coming on. He's got it. And the inning is over. Fine play by David in right center field. No hits, no runs, no errors. One left. We go to the bottom half of the third. No score.
Monday on TBS, five Labor Day blockbusters. First, Rodney Dangerfield's going cold turkey.
Does that go for beer, too?
It's easy money.
Then, Helen Slater hungers for justice. The legend of Billie Jean. Next, Burt Reynolds and a cast of thousands. Smokey and the Bandit, followed by Smokey and the Bandit 2. Then, Chuck Norris, Lone Wolf McQuade. TBS Labor Day blockbusters begins 10:05 Eastern Monday on TBS.
Great play by David Justice, saved a run here. A lot of guys dive and skid just to make plays look tougher than they are, but if he isn't stretched flat out there, he didn't make this play. So no style points here, just all-out effort.
Damon Berryhill leads off the bottom of the third. And pops one foul back, 0-1. So the Giants are turned back again. They're 0-for-6 with runners in scoring position. The 0-1 pitch, chopped to short. Clayton Waits, good play on a funny hop and throws him out. That was a tough play. Sort of an in-between hopper for him, but he handled it. One away.
Five of the seven outs, results ground balls. Watch the overspin here. Comes right at him, but he's got good reflexes. Plays it shoulder high, unloads in a hurry. Even with the catcher running, you'll find him unloading in a hurry. That'll give the first baseman a chance to, if it is a little off, to go get the ball and come back to the bag. Good habit to learn early.
Mark Lemke, the batter. Low and inside, one ball, no strikes. Interesting statistic on Lemke. He's hitting 260 for the year, but from the seventh inning on, he's batted at a 291 clip. Which means some big hits come from him. Two down. Another ground ball. Only the line drive by Justice has been hit in the air for Atlanta tonight. Greg Maddux is the batter, hitting at 151 on the year. Yeah. two out, nobody aboard. This is a different Bill Swift than the man we saw in San Francisco, and that doesn't surprise you. He's a tough competitor.
Same location with the pitches, but now this game movement. The other time they were just straight, muscled up. I bet he had better velocity on the radar gun in San Francisco. That's not what he looks at.
0-1. You know he's a good competitor. He had to compete at the dinner table. He's one of 15 children. Oh, and two.
Don't you know that his mother had to be the master of some creative cooking, too, didn't she?
I would imagine. Strike three called, and the inning is over just like that. Strikeout number two for Swift. At the end of three, we are scoreless in Atlanta. The NFL on TNT returns this Sunday as the Houston Oilers take on the New Orleans Saints from the Superdome to kick off the regular season. Coverage begins at 7:30 Eastern with the Silver Bullet Stadium Show. That's Sunday night on our sister station, TNT. We go to the fourth, and here with the play-by-play story, Don Sutton.
All right, Skip, thank you much. It's going to be Bonds leading it off, Benzinger and Clayton to follow. Bonds has served notice his first time up. He wasn't going to be shut out. A base hit and a stolen base. Takes the first one down low, 1-0. But for a guy with 100 RBIs, this is right where you want him, leading off an inning. Maybe not this time. That's deep to right center field. That's gone, and the Giants lead it 1-0. That's the sixth home run in his career off Greg Maddux. He is now 22 out of 68.
And brother, he mashed it. He hit some hitter. That's 39 of them, 101 RBIs, and nothing cheap about it. And no doubt from the moment it left the bat. Fastball toward the outside part of the plate, tailing away, but not as far away as Greg wanted it.
Here's Benzinger. He grounded to first his first time up. 1-0 Giants. That'll get out of play, and it's 0-1.
First Giant lead of this of these four games late in the year. But again, to prove your point, that's why you like him up there with nobody on base.
That's only one run. Benzinger has had a productive year for the Giants when he's been able to play. Doesn't get that one, and it's 0-2. Giants have had winning seasons five out of their last 7 years, but they've only been able to win on the road in one of those years. Even back in 89 when they won it, they were three games under 500 on the road. That'll take care of Benson. Perfect pitch. Maddux rings up his second strikeout.
We mentioned before, 0-2, he likes to go after the hitter, and he does that here. That one tailed back right where he wanted it, over the inside corner.
And here comes Clayton. He tapped back to the pitcher. A big out in the second inning. Bonds had led it off with a single. He stole second, went to third on a ground out. And Clayton, first pitch swinging, grounded back to Maddux. Takes a strike, and it's 0-1. When the Giants won it in 89, they were 25 games over 500. At home. Off the fist. Fair foul. Foul ball, and it's 0-2. But they were three games under 500 on the road. This year, about the same. They're 44-22 at home, but they're 18 over on the road at 41-23.
We should point out, too, they go to St. Louis when this series is over, and the Braves stay home and play the Padres.
We told you earlier, when they get on the board first, they're tough to beat. 1-2 to Clayton. Tonight's ballgame might also dictate. We have heard back and forth that Hickerson, if he is not used tonight, will be the starting pitcher, but Dusty Baker wouldn't hesitate bringing him out of the pen if it would help him get a win. To Lemke. To McGriff. Two outs. And Manwaring is the hitter. Last time up, got hit by a pitch. Another guy who's had quietly, much like Mark Lemke, has had a good year for the Giants. Five home runs, 43 RBIs out of the eighth spot, hitting right at 280. Upstairs, and it's 1-0.
His average has been in a little bit of a decline, and that happens to a lot of catchers who catch virtually every day. The heat and the squatting just really takes its toll as the year goes on.
Back into the stands, and it's 1-1. That's why some of the years had by catchers like Thurman Munson, when he used to hit, are so remarkable.
Roy Campanella, Yogi Berra, those guys. Yeah.
Bench. That's a tough job being back there every night. 1-1 to Manwaring. Make it 1-2. Boy, Maddux doesn't give an inch after a home run to a guy like Bonds.
Well, that's the mark of a great player. He's just as composed as can be. Inside, he's probably upset, but he concentrates on business.
Just missed. That'll even it at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Another one out of play, still 2-2. Manwaring, one of those guys that puts it in play. He has less than 60 strikeouts, and he is pushing about 400 at-bats for the year. 1-0 Giants. A Barry Bonds homer has put him on top. It is also quieted a somewhat vocal crowd, but only a couple of swings of the bat by the Braves will get him right back in it. Didn't mean to. Still 2-2. Chance for Blauser. Good thing it's a catcher running. He throws him out by plenty. Well, the Giants only get one hit in an inning, but it's a big one. One swing of the bat by Barry Bonds has put him on top. 1-0. Braves coming up middle of the fourth, trail the Giants.
Here's a look at our score and elsewhere in the National League this afternoon. Mike Morgan got the win as the Cubs beat the Phillies. Florida's put a run on the board, likewise the Dodgers. Ed Taubensy has a homer as Houston's taken the lead. The other action is later in the American League. Thomas, a two-run homer, his 100th in his career to give the White Sox the lead over the Yankees. Texas 2-0, Rogers against Clemens, no score in Minnesota. Kansas City a run in the first at Milwaukee, and the other action later on. That's all the other baseball up to the minute.
1-0 Giants. Bill Swift has faced the minimum. He gave up a walk to Blauser, but Gant hit into the 6-4-3 double play. Nixon will lead it off here in the bottom of the fourth inning. A run on 3 hits for the Giants. Zeros across for the Braves. Ball one. This is downstairs. And it's 1-0 to Nixon. First time up, struck out swinging. 3 out of 7 in his career against the Giants right-hander. Inside, and it's 2-0. That's how he started with Otis the first time up. Swift, one of 3 pitchers that came down from Seattle in a trade that sent Kevin Mitchell up north. The left field, that's going to get over Bonds' head, or is it? Nice running catch. That looked like it was headed for the corner. He takes extra bases away from Otis Nixon. One gone.
The other thing you forget about him, he's really an outstanding outfielder. His arm is only average, but he can go get the ball as well as anybody. Otis took a shot that way, inside out of the ball, and I thought we were in business, but fine running catch, and then a little how do you do off the TBS sign.
And made it.
You'll be billed for that, Barry.
And made it look easy. Here's Blauser. He takes ball one outside. A strike to Jeff. First time up, he walked. Two and one. Blazer wore out the Cubs, but doesn't he always? He was 8 out of 11, a double, a triple, and two RBIs in the Cubs series. A strike, says Frank Pulley, and it's 2-2. Full count to Blazer. If you've tracked Jeff Blazer's progress, you'll know as he has gotten better as a hitter, his base on ball totals have gone up. His strikeout totals have gone down. To right field, it's a base hit. Good piece of hitting by Blazer, and the Braves dent the hit column.
Blazer red hot. That's 24 hits in his last 44 at bats.
And he's at first base for Ron Gant. Blazer represents a tying run. Again, a sharp grounder to Clayton the first time up. He turned it into a 6-4-3 double play. I honestly think with Nixon being a base stealer, Deion Sanders being a base stealer, Justice and Blazer draw more throws than those two guys combined. It's almost automatic for Blazer. Make it two and make him safe. Gant, 2 out of 9 against Bill Swift. Lays off the breaking ball. It's 1-0. You know, I was a little bit surprised when Gant grounded into a double play with his speed and everything, but he's second on the ball club in that category. McGriff is grounded into 14, Pendleton 14. But that one, an even dozen to run. And Bill Swift is a guy who can throw up some twin killings. And can throw to first.
Yeah, with that sinker ball, you're going to get a lot of ground ball.
Blazer's single has gotten the crowd back into this one. A little bit out in front of it. That's going to hook foul. Even at that 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out. 1-0 Giants. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning from Atlanta. And a great evening for baseball. And this crowd started gathering early, and I guess a lot of the restaurants and taverns were having events leading up the parades for this ball game. It's like a playoff atmosphere. On the ground, could be two, but Clayton can't handle it. Probably scored that a hit. That would have been a tough chance for Clayton. It is going to be a single.
He made the tough part. He got to the ball. But then when he reached into his glove, I don't know how you can call that a hit, but they did. And he makes the play, and then he drops the ball.
He had time to get the force at second. That's a break for the Braves. It'll put him at first and second and bring up Fred McGriff. McGriff had a good weekend against the Cubs, too. He's 5 out of 13. He had a double. He also had his 31st homer and 4 RBIs.
You want to ensure a Braves win, get McGriff to hit a homer. They've won 9 out of 10 of the ball games that he's hit a homer in. One right here would make it 3-1. Outside, and it's 1-0. Blauser at second, Gant at first, 1-0 Giants. McGriff, a 375 hitter against Swift. Ball two misses inside.
We're able to see a pretty good swing here.
He lays off a good pitch. And Swift, one pitch away from loading him up for David Justice. Is McGriff green lighted 3-0? We'll soon see. Doesn't matter. That's ball four. Second base on ball issued by Billy Swift, and the bases are loaded for David Justice. Dusty Baker's going to make his way out to the mound. What do you tell him here? Don't give him anything good to hit and don't walk him?
Yeah, you got to throw him a strike. And Justice hit the daylights out of the ball his first time. He's 3 out of 11 in his career against Swift, and two of those hits, home run. One now, and this place would be up for grabs.
It's sometimes tough to do if you're a pitcher. You try to get so fine. But Swift has got to be willing to trade another fly ball for an out here on David Justice. What he has in this matchup is that he's got a ground ball pitcher against a fly ball hitter. Justice, 34 homers, 92 RBIs, tops on the ball club. And near the top of the heap in the National League. To left field, base hit. Here comes Blauser, here comes Gant. The throw will go to third. It's 2-1 Braves.
A nice piece of hitting. He just took the ball where it was pitched and hit it high.
You know what? Something overlooked a lot of times is a job Jeff Blauser did there. He saved Ron Gant some wear and tear. McGriff's at second, Justice is at first. The chant very much evident. Pendleton fouls the first one out of play.
And the first Giant lead in these four games lasts less than a half inning.
And you pegged it right. A good piece of hitting by David Justice. He didn't try to get four with one swing. He just wanted to make sure he got one, and he got two in the process. Pendleton ground ball to short his first time up. Takes it outside. It's 1-1. Once again, it's the heart of the Braves order. Blauser started it. Gant, McGriff, and Justice came through. One and two to Pendleton.
Swift and Burkett, you know, the two aces of the Giants staff in the last six starts, have no wins between them, and that's going into tonight's game.
And when you only have two aces to choose from, it doesn't help you win. Giants have had to rely so much on offense.
Good breaking ball from Billy Swift. But Pendleton stays alive, and it's still 1-2. Lauser's single with one out. Gant followed with a single. McGriff walked to load him up. And then Justice served one to left field. 2-1 Braves. Two to Pendleton. That's the pitch earlier in the year Pendleton couldn't lay off of. Anything on the inside part of the plate, whether it were a fastball or a breaking ball, Terry was swinging right through it. But much more comfortable the second half of the season.
By the way, David Justice has moved to within 7 RBIs of the league lead. He's just 7 behind Bonds and now in second place.
Got him with a good sinker. Third strikeout for Billy Swift. It'll bring up Damon Berryhill.
Look at the action here. The bottom just drops out of it.
And Pendleton looked amazed that he missed that. He was right on it. It would cross the plate. Here's Berryhill. Berryhill, a grounder to short. His first time up. 2 out of 12 in his career against the Giants right-hander. Takes a breaking ball inside, and it's 1-0. This sinker misses downstairs, and it's 2-0 to Berryhill. Swift averages right at 2 base on balls per 9 innings. One of the best control artists in the National League. Did he check his swing? No, he did not go around, and it's 3-0 to Berryhill. McGriff didn't swing 3-0. Let's see if Berryhill is green-lighted. He is. Ground ball, fair ball. Extra bases. Here comes McGriff. Justice hung up between third and home, but scrambles back. Berryhill gets the green light and an RBI.
Bobby Cox, a riverboat gambler, turns him loose. He went down and got a pretty good pitch and got it just by a diving Benzinger.
Berryhill stopped at first. Justice is at third, and here's Mark Lemke. 4 hits and a walk in the inning, and the Braves lead it 3-1. Good stop by Man Wieren. It's 1-0 to Lemke. Justice will score. Berryhill scores. A 2-run double for Lemke. It's 5-1 Braves.
He got that pitch up. Martinez had him played into right center. And Barry Hill, despite his lack of speed, never hesitated, and that's what got him home. Look at him bear down. He makes it easily. And all of a sudden, Swift is getting everything up, and when he does that, he's a very hittable pitcher. Bob Brindley down in their dugout looking on. And Jeff Brantley gets up and begins to throw.
Something Dusty Baker didn't want to have to do, go to that bullpen early. But the Braves have put five on the board here in the fourth inning, and they lead it 5-1. A very short lead for the Giants. Ninth man to hit in the inning, it's Greg Maddux. Back to Swift. That should take care of the inning. It does. But not before the Braves faithful have something to cheer about. The Braves put five on the board. They do it on five hits, including two RBIs out of Justice and Lemke. We'll head to the fifth inning. Braves lead it 5-1.
Long way to go in this one, but tomorrow night's game will be on Sports South at 7:30, and then we'll be back with you on Thursday night. And Friday, the Padres come to call.
5-1 Braves, top of the fifth inning. It'll be Swift leading it off. Five runs, five hits for the Braves. 1-3-0 for the Giants. Here's strike two to Swift. You picked a pretty good guy to have out there if you want somebody to hand the lead to, and Maddux. Not thankfully flinched, but didn't quite get the right arm up, and it's 1-2. He'll get it up this time. Strikeout number three for Maddux. One gone in the fifth.
This has to be very disheartening for the Giants. They finally get a lead and say, well, now things are going our way. Here we go. And before you can blink, they're down 5-1.
And if you look in the dugout, you really can't tell who's in first place, can you?
Now, the pressure, I felt the pressure last week was very much on us. Now it's pretty much equal, I think. And right now it's certainly more on the Giants.
Top of the batting order, Dave Martinez. You see what he's done. Braves shade him toward the off field in the outfield, play him almost straight up and deep in the infield. There's a strike, and it's 0-1. Nothing but strikes out of Greg Maddux. You see the alignment. Nixon over in left center field. Lemke will be a step back on the grass at second. Off the fist out of play, and it's 0-2. This is inside, and it's 1-2, and this crowd, which was awfully quiet for 3.5 innings, deathly quiet for half an inning.
Well, they're all staring at the blue moon, which doesn't come back again until what,
1996? 2-2.
No, better not.
Of ourselves, from the 50s. Group out of Philadelphia.
Our group might be in Philadelphia.
Keep
going like they're going.
2-2 to Martinez. Popped up. Barry Hill's there, but here comes Pendleton. Pendleton takes charge. Two gone. And this is exactly the kind of pitching you want out of your pitcher. When you give him a lead, you want somebody that goes out, will work quickly, throw the ball over the plate, and force him to put it in play. It's exactly what Maddux has done. Quickly, two are gone here in the top of the fifth inning. They'll bring up Robbie Thompson. Quiet tonight. He's grounded to second. He's flied to right field. But that's news. He has passed Barry Bonds, and Bonds may have caught him tonight. He started the night being ahead of Bonds in the hitters in the batting race. Takes a ball, 1-0.
inside corner, and it's 1-1. Ground ball. Pendleton's got it. McGriff's got it. There go the Giants. 1-2-3. Maddux sets him down. We're halfway home. Braves lead this one 5-1.
A five-run bottom half of the fourth inning, giving Atlanta a 5-1 lead. And doing a couple of other things, Joe Simpson. Number one, when Barry Bonds hit that home run in the top half of the fourth inning, it was like he was delivering a message to these Braves fans saying, not this year.
You know, it's one thing, you know, when you've got your leader that does what he did, hitting the home run to get his ball club going, it can be so demoralizing when you take the field then, and to see the opponents come back and slap you with a five spot like the Braves did. You think you're doing all you can to try to help. But for that individual, it can be so tough on you, thinking you're doing all you can and it's still not enough.
Third time around the order for the Braves against Bill Swift. They couldn't do anything the first time around, but a five-run fourth as all nine came to the plate in the fourth inning. And Otis Nixon takes ball one. He's 0 for 2. He gets struck out and flied to left. Inside corner, 1-1.
And let's not shortchange the effect of the crowd, too, Pete. I'm sure that Billy Swift a little rattled, especially after he had loaded the bases up when Justice stepped up there.
The 1-1 taken low, 2-1. The Giants have heard this chant and seen this chop before, but never at the level that they saw it in the fourth inning. Because they were not the team the Braves were involved in the race with the last 2 years. And that's when it seems to reach its peak. 3-1 the count now on Otis Nixon. Blauser will follow and then Gant. It's full now. 3-2 on Otis. Inside corner. Otis Nixon complaining the pitch was low to Frank Pulley. But he's going to be called out on strikes. And still can't believe Pulley's call. Fourth strikeout of the night for Billy Swift.
Watch this, the movement on this pitch. The bottom drops out of it, and it looks worse than it is because Manwaring had to make sure that he caught the ball. And by taking his glove down after making the catch made it look like a real bad pitch, and it wasn't. It was a pretty good one.
And now Jeff Blauser, a walk and a single tonight. Ground ball to the right side. He's been taking a lot of shots to right. Ball bobbled by Thompson. He can't throw him out. Robbie Thompson had it, lost it, and couldn't find it in time. And the usually sure-handed Giants second baseman charged with an error here.
And that was the epitome of a boot because it was at his feet, and he really kind of kicked it away from himself.
That is only his eighth error of the season.
You know, there are a lot of young players who would have probably picked that ball up and tried to fire it to first no matter what was going on. But rather than make two errors on the same play, he decided to eat it and hope that Swift can get a ground ball and get out of the inning.
He got one from Gant in the first inning when Ron hit into a 6-4-3 double play. Then an infield single for Gant in the fourth inning. Outside corner for a strike, nothing and one. Blauser, much more of a threat to run this year than ever before in his career. 14 steals in 19 tries. That missed high. One ball, one strike.
I think that's the pitch that's really given Swift trouble in the last two starts against Atlanta. His slider has not been very sharp. He's got that excellent sinker that was not working well for him in San Francisco. It has been working tonight. But he hasn't been sharp with his slider, and he needs that to keep the Braves right-handers honest.
Up high, 2-1. There had been some reports circulating that because his arm was tiring a bit, Billy Swift was going to be kept to a 90-pitch limit. in his remaining starts this year. But we checked with the Giants, as you see Dave Righetti up now in their bullpen, and they say that's not true. They say all season long, it's been a known factor that Swift begins to lose some of his effectiveness at about 100 pitches, but there's no limit at all on him. If he's going good, he's going to stay in there. I'll tell you one thing that fourth inning did was use up a lot of those Billy Swift pitches. He threw 30 pitches the first three innings, 30 in the fourth. Manwaring throws out Gant. Now the second goes Blauser, two down. And that'll bring up Fred McGriff.
Nice play.
Drew a walk.
Excuse me, Pete. Nice play by the catcher. He saved the run last inning with a ball in the dirt. Justice eventually came on to score anyway, but Manwaring's done a good job back there tonight. He pounced on this one quickly. Their defense, outstanding, even in the absence of Will Clark and Darren Lewis.
Yeah, you don't lose much with Benzinger at first and Martinez out in center defensively.
No.
McGriff 0 for 1 with a walk. Two outs. Blauser down at second. McGriff takes the ball. 0 and inside. Deep to right center field on the run. Willie McGee can't get it off the wall. Around third, Blauser. He scores. Down to second, Fred McGriff. It's 6-1 Atlanta. A two-out run-scoring double by the Crime Dog.
Pete, this ball wasn't hit all that well. Hit it off the end of the bat, but he is so strong. Great bat speed, great torque in his swing, and even hitting one just off the end of the bat, he's able to drive it out near the warning track and split Martinez and McGee perfectly. And that's it for Billy Swift.
He makes it through 4 2/3 innings after lasting 4 1/3 innings against the Braves in his start at Candlestick Park. Dave Righetti, the new Giants pitcher. They tell you this is how you beat the San Francisco Giants. Get into their bullpen early. If their starters give you innings and they get to their setup guys like Mike Jackson and their closer like Rod Beck, you're going to have a tough time beating them. But in the last four games in these last two series, Giants starters have not been around long.
Dusty Baker working up a pretty good lather over there, and with just cause, because the Braves have roughed up that starting pitching of the Giants, the area where they have really struggled with
and
the injuries.
And these long and middle men for the Giants, like Dave Righetti, not having that big a year. You saw his earned run average, 4.54. He's allowed 9 home runs in just 41 2/3 innings. And you feel you have a chance to add to your lead when you get into the middle innings and into the Giants bullpen. It's 6-1 Atlanta, two outs in the fifth. Justice, a two-run single his last time up, now has driven in 94 runs this year. Taking ball one inside.
Pete, it's not just Dave Righetti that's been giving up some home runs in their bullpen. There are other guys down there that have given up some long ones.
Here's the 1-0 pitch on the way, and that almost hit Justice.
This was bound to happen. Inside target. One right up under the chin. Wasn't throwing at him. Just a little reminder that we're still here, guys. And Righetti, the grizzled veteran that he is, the one that took it upon himself to do that.
Again, it's high in the count, 3-0. 6 runs, 6 hits for Atlanta, 1 run, 3 hits, and 1 error for the San Francisco Giants, and that error has led to an unearned run here in the bottom half of the fifth inning.
That's a lot of long balls out of your bullpen in 1 month.
Deep to right field, this ball is gone. It is 8
on number 35 and 96 RBIs in the year now for David Justice.
Folks, there's not a better reply in the world than this right here. That's the sweetest home run David Justice has hit this year out of 35. You get low bridge, knocked right on the seat of your pants, and you get up and you hit one in the seats. That was beautiful.
And it appears that another rout is on. 8-1 Atlanta, bottom half of the fifth inning with two outs. Terry Pendleton takes a strike at the knees. Nothing at one.
Five straight days for Justice, is that right? Home runs?
Right. Already this crowd chanting sweep. Long ways to go before I can even think about that. Willie McGee waits for this one. And that'll do it for the Braves in the fifth, but they put three more on the board. And after five, it's 8-1 Atlanta.
It's party time so far in Atlanta after five innings. 8-1 Braves. Now time for the Aflac trivia question. Which Hall of Famer was known? Well, we'll give it to you after this pitch.
That's a tough question. Which Hall of Famer was known? Oh, there's more.
Was known as the Raja. That's the Aflac trivia question tonight. We'll give you the answer in the bottom half of the inning.
Here's the 1-0 pitch to McGee on the ground to short. Blauser doubles it up on the first. One gone in the sixth. And Joe, here's another portion of a ball game, a lopsided game like this, where the Braves starting pitching comes in. You gave Greg Maddux a 7-run lead into the sixth inning. You got to feel pretty good about your chances. Braves starting pitching has been outstanding all year, but especially in the second half. And you get a guy like Maddux a lead like this.
Another reason to be demoralized in the Giant dugout. Also, you got to like the way he just attacks. He goes first pitch strike almost every guy that comes up there now.
Matt Williams tonight 0-for-2. He's grounded out to first and fly to right. It's been a while since the Braves have played, having the off day yesterday, and all you've heard around Atlanta for the last 2 days is speculation on can this club sweep again. I'll tell you what, in the Braves clubhouse prior to the game tonight, nobody talking about sweep. Everybody talking about one thing: tonight's game.
It's ridiculous. Ridiculous for people to expect it.
Here's the one strike delivery, and it's inside. One ball, one strike. This ball club has done a remarkable job each of the last 3 years of not getting caught up in all the media and fan ballyhoo down the stretch. They've really remained a sharply focused group. Foul back, and if you ask the players about it, as I did Mark Lemke tonight, they attribute that to the front office and the way they conduct themselves, nobody getting too hysterically high or low after a win or a loss, and also the way Bobby Cox and his coaches conduct themselves, and the way leaders in the club like Terry Pendleton and Sid Bream, the influence they've had on the younger players.
Very professional, top to bottom.
A ball and two strikes on Williams. Well hit to left field. Long run for Ron Gant. Can't get to this one. It's going to bounce off the wall. Williams will wind up at second with a one-out double. And for Matt Williams, his 28th double of the year.
Maddux left a couple of pitches up high to Williams in this at-bat. This, the last one. And that was shoulder high, and he hammered it. Greg got a changeup up there. Left a breaking ball upstairs, a pitch before that that he fouled back.
That's the fourth hit off of Greg Maddux, and two of them belong to the next hitter, Barry Bonds, who had a base hit in the second inning and his 39th home run of the year, leading off the fourth inning. That gave the Giants a 1-0 lead. Since his last at bat, Giants have fallen behind 8-1.
I know everybody's a little giddy over a 7-run lead at this point, even with Maddux out there, but the Giants in that series at Candlestick, when they did score, it was usually late. Three runs in the fifth inning of game one, four innings over the last four innings of game two.
1-0 pitch to Bond, strike in the inside corner, 1-1. One man out, Williams down at second. Bonds with two hits and a great catch in the game already tonight. Up to 341 now for the year. Up and in, 2-1.
And even as an opponent, Pete, when Dave Justice did what he did after getting knocked down and to step back up there and hit one out of the ballpark, there's not a guy in a gray uniform that didn't respect what he did and didn't gain a little respect.
Now the 2-1 delivery, foul back. And the count even now, 2-2 on Bonds.
I was talking to a scout before the ball game about pitching to Barry Bonds, and we were discussing how the Braves have done a good job of pitching him inside, and he talked about how, yeah, you can pitch him inside, but there's such a fine line there.
I tell you what Greg Maddux said about that very thing? He said there is a hole there, but it's a very tiny one. Here's the 2-2. Ground ball fouled on the right side.
Yeah, if you keep it in on his belt buckle a little bit, it's actually a ball. What we're talking about, that hole is actually probably a ball inside off the plate. If you start coming over the white part of home plate inside, throw it and duck.
So that hole is just about big enough for a baseball to pass through. Yeah. 2-2, the count on Bonds.
And he can hit it. Maddux can hit that hole.
Fouled back again, still 2-2 on Barry Bonds.
But see, that's the wonderful thing about what Atlanta's offense has done in their three plus games with the Giants here of late. They've scored early and often. They've given the pitchers the opportunity to challenge Barry Bonds or Matt Williams with some pitches inside. And more often than not, it's been resulting in some outs. They may not pitch the same way in a close ball game.
Here's the 2-2. He tried to hit that hole right there and missed inside. 3-2.
But don't look for Maddux to be fancy here. He's not going to be trying to fool him with a 7-run lead. Maybe a changeup, but that's the most.
It is, and Bonds is right on it. Base hit to left field. They'll hold the runner at third. You're not going to see a lot of chances taken on the bases right now by the Giants. Runners first and third, one down. Barry Bonds, 3-for-3 on the night. And that'll bring up Todd Benzinger, who's grounded out to first and struck out.
He's pitched in trouble tonight. He hasn't had a breezy night by any means.
Only 1-1-2-3 inning. That was the fifth, but you're right. He left a runner at second in the first inning. He had a runner at third and one out in the second. Got out of that. Another runner at second in the third. And now they're at first and third. And so far, the only run, that solo homer by Barry Bonds. He was chased back.
Giants tonight were 0-for-6 with runners in scoring position before that base hit by Bonds. He gets a hit, but the run still didn't score.
And even down by 7, don't be surprised if Barry Bonds might take off here. He's going right there. Ground ball hit to second. Lemke's only play will be on to first. A run scores, and Bonds advances to second. He almost takes it upon himself to get his club going. He really picks his spots to run.
He's capable. He's capable of doing it all himself. Tonight, 3-for-3, a home run, a stolen base, a great defensive play to take a hit and extra bases away from Otis Nixon.
See, all he had in mind there was not staying out of the double play. He was going to try to swipe second, so if Benzinger got a base hit, it meant two runs.
Right.
Instead, there's a ground out, one run is in. It's 8-2. And here's Royce Clayton. He's 0-for-2. He's bounced to the pitcher, grounded out to second. Takes a strike, 0-1. This lower third of the order. Pretty good numbers for the year, but not so hot numbers for the last month or so. Clayton just 217 over his last 31 games, and Manwaring is on deck as 4 for his last 46. Bond's going to try to swipe third, and he's got it. And he's in a position now where a wild pitch or a pass ball means another run. So he's stolen two bases in this inning. He had one back in the second, and he's got three tonight, but still only 23 in the air. That's what we mean by being very selective about when he runs.
Well, he didn't get a stolen base on the ground out. He got the second on the ball hit, but he does have two stolen bases tonight. And this is the way the Giants have played all year, Pete. Even when they're behind, they're not afraid to run and take the extra bag.
You're right, he was running, but did not get the stolen base, obviously, on the ground out. 22 steals on the year. As the count goes to 2-1 now on Royce Clayton. Into center field, Nixon had him played perfectly. That's it for the Giants in the sixth. They pick up one, but that's all. Another runner left at third. And we go to the bottom half of the sixth inning, 8-2 Atlanta.
Wednesday night.
They're a bunch of eight balls. Half of them, if they don't belong in jail, should be put in a loony bin.
They're the laughing stock of the Army with one last chance to prove they're soldiers.
Now, frankly, I don't know what to expect from your men.
Fire!
As of now, man for man, they're the best combat unit in the world.
In the tradition of the Dirty Dozen, William Holden and the true story of the renowned fighting unit, the Devil's Brigade. 8:05 Eastern, Wednesday night on TBS.
8-2 Atlanta as we go to the bottom half of the sixth inning, and time to give you the answer to tonight's Aflac trivia question. Which Hall of Famer was known as the Raja? Rogers Hornsby will be the correct answer.
And as we go to the bottom half of the sixth inning, the lower third of the order, Damon Berryhill, Mark Lemke, and Greg Maddux. This portion of the order very instrumental in that five-run fourth inning. Berryhill had a two-out run scoring single. Mark Lemke had a two-out, two-run double. Dave Righetti, who came on for Billy Swift. Swift, by the way, 4 2/3 innings, 6 hits, 7 runs, 5 earned, 2 walks, 4 strikeouts. And it's 0-1 now on Damon Berryhill. Here's the one strike pitch, another base hit for Berryhill. He's 2-for-3. And a good start for Atlanta in the bottom half of the sixth inning.
Hey, old Damon has really picked it up of late. He hit the home run in San Francisco, and he hasn't hit that many long balls recently. In fact, his comment was, you know, it's a shame a guy can hit the ball that far, doesn't have any more than 6 home runs. But he's been getting a lot of hits, and none bigger really than the one he got with 2 outs in the fourth inning.
You go back over his last 11 games, he's got 14 hits in his last 41 at bats. That's close to 350. Lemke 1-for-2 with that two-run double. Berryhill not being held, they're going to send him, and Lemke finds the vacated spot. Berryhill's going to take a big turn and go back as Bonds quickly gets to the ball. Braves playing some hit and run. Lemke delivers the base hit. But because Bonds got to the ball so quickly, they're still at first and second.
They got the fans buzzing, too. Barry Bonds has filled up just a notch in just about every category tonight except an assist, and he was about to register one when Damon Wisely threw the brakes on. Good job by Lemke on the hit and run, picking the right spot for the base knock.
Now Robbie Thompson, Matt Williams meet with Righetti and catcher Kurt Manwaring. They'll talk about bunt coverage here with Greg Maddux up. And Jeff Brantley up again in the Giants bullpen. Maddux on the air, 7 sacrifice hits. Avery has 8, Glavin has 8, Smoltz has 8.
Giants outfield certainly looking for a bunt here, Pete. Look how shallow they're playing Maddux.
And a pickoff play out at second. That's one of the things that was talked about during that meeting. Let's try it once. But Berryhill got back.
They're just ready to back up a throw.
Maddux swinging after showing button hits it foul off to the left. I'll tell you what, he had the whole left side of the infield open. As that wheel play was on, all he was trying to do was hit a ground ball to the left side.
Third baseman charges, the shortstop goes over to cover third. That leaves a huge hole on the left side of the diamond. Good try by Greg and a good idea that he had no room to bunt, and he's got a slow runner at second.
It's nothing and one on Maddux. Benzinger camped about 4 or 5 feet in on the grass at first. Here comes Williams creeping in from third. This time the butt is to Matt Williams. He'll have a play at third. In time there, the throw across by Clayton pulls Benzinger off the bag, or pulls Thompson off the bag, rather, and Maddux is safe at first. So the Giants made it almost impossible for Greg Maddux to get a successful bunt down. They get the force play at third.
Damon Berryhill couldn't get to third in time on this bunt, but one thing he did was slow Clayton down a little bit on his throw. Took a little starch out of that throw as he knocked his back leg out from under him, almost caused him to throw it away.
Still first and second, but one out now, and the batter will be Otis Nixon, who is 0 for 3 tonight with a couple of strikeouts. The last one coming on a disputed call. Tomorrow being the 1st of September, Braves will be able to expand their rosters. Greg Olson will be back. Deion Sanders will be back. Pete Smith will be back. The call-ups from Richmond will not come, according to John Schuerholz, until after the Richmond season ends, including playoffs. I know the count on Nixon. Clayton to Thompson, one. Thompson on to first. Good slide down at second base by Greg Maddux. And Robbie Thompson's throw to first off target. How about that? A pitcher.
Yeah, most of the time you just see him peel off out of the way. Not Greg Maddux. He went after him. May have caught Robbie Thompson by surprise because he took the throw behind the back, thought he was going to have an easy time of it.
So some heads-up base running by Greg Maddux keeps the inning going. First and third now with two outs for Jeff Blauser. Tonight he's walked, singled, and reached on an error by Robbie Thompson.
And don't be surprised if Otis Nixon doesn't try to swipe a bag here.
The breaking ball missing inside, a ball and no strikes on Blauser.
And even if he doesn't, you just saw Righetti change his delivery a little bit with Otis at first base, and that may work to Blauser's advantage. Instead of going to that high leg kick, Righetti just tried to make a quick step to the plate.
Got a strike that time with a fastball. It's 1-1. 8 runs, 9 hits for Atlanta, 2 runs, 5 hits for the Giants. Good stop again by Manwaring, 2-1 the count.
He's done a great job tonight. Sweating bullets back there on a warm, humid night and keeping everything in front of him.
Nixon chased back. Little chopper to third. Matt Williams fighting the lights a little bit there on that high chopper. Throws out Blauser. And that'll do it for Atlanta in the sixth inning. This time Righetti gets out of it with no damage done. A pair of runners left. We go to the seventh. 8-2 Atlanta.
More Braves and Giants on television for you tomorrow night for you folks in the Southeast. The game will be at 7:30 on Sports South. That'll be John Smoltz against Brian Hickerson, Ernie Johnson Jr. and Sr. Then we'll be back with you on TBS on Thursday night, 7:35. Steve Avery against John Burkett right here. So be with us and don't miss the action.
Here's Kurt Manwaring looping one into shallow right center field. Nixon had him shaded that way. One pitch, one out in the seventh. Manwaring now 0 for 2 tonight. And now we will get a pinch hitter, Steve Scarsone, batting for Dave Righetti.
We've been quick to praise Barry Bonds tonight, and rightfully so. He's had a perfect night at the plate, played well defensively, but let's not forget the Braves right fielder either and that great catch he made to save a run early in the ball game. Was at the third inning when he robbed Matt Williams on that broken bat hit, and then all he's done is pick up an RBI hit and two-run homer.
There's a call strike. Well, a game like this, you expect the stars to shine, and indeed they have tonight. One and one the count now on Scarsone. 288 for the year with a homer and 12 RBIs. 3 out of 8 is a pinch hitter. He's done a good job, did a good job filling in when Matt Williams was out with an injury. It's one on one, hop to Pendleton. And quickly, two are down here in the top half of the seventh inning. And we're back to the top of the order, Dave Martinez. If the Braves can hold on here, you got to like their chances with Maddux out there in a six-run lead. The lead will be down to 3.5 games, but believe me, you can walk in that Atlanta clubhouse, and it'll look no different than it did last May when the Braves were struggling.
Doing the job.
Two gone. Martinez, a single, a walk, and a foul out.
Giants starting pitching has not done the job the last four games between these two ball clubs. Braves starting pitching has done quite a number. An ERA just over 2 so far.
Two and oh, the count on Dave Martinez. One advantage the Braves starters may have over the Giants starters going into a stretch drive like this is their experience in working 200 plus innings.
Good point.
All of these guys have done that before on numerous occasions. And we're getting into uncharted waters on Billy Swift, John Burkett, and people like that on the Giants staff who've never worked this many innings before.
And even think about the days that Maddux and Glavin worked on 3 days rest.
Line toward left field. Gant coming on. He's got it. And Maddux has his second 1-2-3 inning of the night. Seventh inning stretch time coming up. These fans will be in good voice. They sing Take Me Out of the Ball Game. It's 8-2 Atlanta. As we go to the bottom half of the seventh inning. The third Giants pitcher of the night, right-hander Jeff Bradley, making his 43rd appearance. He's made 12 starts this year. This will be his 31st relief appearance, and you see the numbers on him. The league hitting .262 this year against Bradley. Righetti worked an inning in the third, gave up 3 hits and a run, no walks or strikeouts.
Their bullpen showing a few signs. We talked about the long balls they had allowed this month, showing a few chinks in their armor. They had been stalwarts down there all season long.
What the Giants have needed these last couple of weeks is innings out of their starters. We've shown you what their starters have done against Atlanta, and that's not been the only team against whom the Giants starting pitching has had trouble delivering big innings. They've had to go to their bullpen quite early. That's why it was such a boost to them when that Solomon Torres, the 21-year-old youngster, came up and gave them 7 strong innings against the Marlins on Sunday.
Scott Sanderson pitched very well
down there, too,
gave him a good start. I asked Mike Jackson, one of the guys for the Giants in the bullpen, about Torres and his start. He said he was outstanding, and actually when he got a balk called on him and it created a run, he said he kept his composure and got right back on track, pitched very well.
Here's the 1-1 to Gant right through there for a called strike, 1-2. Gant tonight, 1-for-3, and an infield hit back in the fourth. Into left field, Bonds is there, and on one knee makes that catch, one down. Fans not appreciative of the style that Barry Bonds showed everybody there, and Barry said, okay, I've got a few more things I'm going to show you before this series is over.
And he will. And most of what you see is really not him taking much of a chance, just being flashy. He caught that ball shoulder high and then went into his snatch mode.
McGriff had a run scoring double his last time up. Behind him, McCown 0-1. With a good fastball, nothing into the count. And the high fastball gets McGriff. Brantley going right up the ladder, got him on three pitches, two down. And now David Justice, who's had a four RBI night.
Another look at Brantley's fastball at the letters. Fred got a good look at it and couldn't lay off.
Justice, a two-run single in the fourth inning, a two-run homer, his 35th of the year in the fifth inning.
And don't forget that rocket he hit in his first at-bat. Drove McGee to the warning track.
And the catch he made in right field and the ball hit by Matt Williams. Robbie Thompson gets him this time on a broken bat grounder. And a 1-2-3 inning for Jeff Brantley. We're going to the eighth inning. Still a six-run Atlanta lead. As we go to the top of the eighth inning, the Braves make one defensive change. Rafael Belliard takes over at second base for Mark Lemke. Lemke has been playing with a little tendonitis in his right shoulder. And with a six-run lead, Bobby Cox gives him the rest of the night off. Robbie Thompson leads off the eighth for the Giants, 0-for-3. And now time call. The organist is still in the midst of one of her favorite songs.
Well, we're playing baseball here, folks. Moonlight Serenade. I have to wait till the middle of the eighth.
Toward third. Backhanded by Pendleton. Quick throw to first in time. Terry, one of the best in the business at making that play.
Watch his front foot, too, as he makes this throw. His front foot went out from under him a little bit as he plants. Skidded on him a little, but he still made an accurate throw for the out. Nice play.
He likes to catch that ball high so he can reach into his glove and get the throw away very quickly. And a chopper like that. Now Willie McGee. McGee 0-for-3 tonight. Strike in the inside corner, 0-1. Maddux continues to pitch very aggressively with a big lead. It's even now, one ball, one strike.
And as we saw in the sixth inning when he gave up a run on two hits to Williams and Bonds, he's probably going to give up a run or two pitching that way, but he's going to get outs mowing them down along the way, too, and that's what he's looking for, the win and get this game over with.
Count goes to 2-1. That was the 100th pitch of the night thrown by Greg Maddux. The way this rotation has been set up, two of the coolest customers in the National League as far as starting pitchers go, opening up these two important series with the Giants. Steve Avery at Candlestick Park last week and now Maddux this week. The bigger the game, the better they like it.
Absolutely, and they have done their job in setting the tone for things, and the offense has chipped in to help terrifically.
Avery pitches here on Thursday night. Still 2-2.
As great as Maddux's control is, being able to hit spots, you would naturally assume he doesn't walk many batters, and he doesn't. Only 6 walks now in his last 45 innings.
Full count now, 3-2 on Willie McGhee. Rafael Belliard throws out McGhee, two down.
Rafael, remember, had the broken bone in the end of his right index finger that kept him on the sidelines for a while.
It's the first game he's played in since back on August 18th.
Still got some tape on the finger.
Batter will be Matt Williams. Had a double and came around to score in the sixth inning. Nothing and one. Strike on Matt Williams. It goes to 2-1. Talking with John Schuerholz yesterday, and one thing that he is amazed at, the lack of injury on this Braves pitching staff all year. You realize the Braves have only had to use 13 pitchers all season long?
It's amazing that, especially from the starting pitchers, that nobody's had to skip a start except for Pete Smith.
And he gives credit, John does, to two people on the Braves staff. Leo Mazzoni for his throwing program, which he says keeps the pitchers strong, and Frank Foltz, who's the conditioning coach for the Atlanta Braves, for putting all of these pitchers in a program to keep them strong throughout the year. He said he's never been, John Schuerholz talk, he's never been through a season where he hasn't had to use at least 16 pitchers. Braves have only needed 13 all year. And are not planning a lot of pitching call-ups when the rosters expand. Still 2-2 on Matt Williams.
Nice to read Mike Birkbeck's name being mentioned, though, among those under consideration, a veteran who's been through the mill a little bit in this game. Be nice to see him get an opportunity to come up here and help out perhaps the last month.
2-2 on Williams. And the 2-2 pitch on the way, and it's a little bit low, 3-2. I'll tell you one problem that John Schuerholz has as far as bringing up a lot of players from Richmond. I don't think that'll happen. He was talking yesterday, there is no room for anybody that's not on the 40-man roster to come up right now. So you may see a couple of names that you thought were coming not come if they're not on the 40-man roster at the moment.
Matt Williams a little late there calling timeout, but Pulley gave it to him anyway.
Into center field, Otis Nixon. Another 1-2-3 inning for Maddux. Bottom half of the eighth coming up. Still 8-2, Atlanta.
You can call toll-free for a Braves catalog any Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. The number, 1-800-433-BRAVES.
As we go to the bottom half of the eighth inning, let's take a look at the National League scoreboard, the Delta scoreboard. Chicago blanked by Philadelphia today. Florida a winner already, 2-1 over San Diego. They're in a rain delay at Pittsburgh. Tobenci and Biggio have homered for Houston. Good game going on at St. Louis, and Montreal has home runs for Marquise Grissom and Will Cordero. We'll give the American League in just a bit.
And leading off the bottom of the eighth for Atlanta is Terry Pendleton. First pitch swinging, fly ball left field. Bonds drifts back and makes the catch, one down.
And here's the American League scoreboard for you. Big series going on in New York with the White Sox and Yankees. It's all White Sox tonight. They have a home run from Frank Thomas, his 37th. Texas beating Roger Clemens. Gonzalez has hit his 40th for the Rangers. Cleveland shutting out Minnesota. Kansas City needs a win, but Milwaukee's giving them fits. The other games are on the West Coast and will get underway a little bit later on.
Damon Berryhill, 2 out of 3 tonight, a run scoring single back in the fourth inning. Taking a strike, 0-1. Due up in the Giants' half of the ninth inning, Bonds, Benzinger, and Clayton. It'll be the fourth time up for Bonds, and three of them will come as a leadoff hitter. It's even now, 1-1. Another sellout crowd tonight, 46,493. And it was one of those nights when everybody got here on time tonight for this one.
I don't think anybody wanted to miss a pitch.
No.
They want to make sure they weren't caught in any traffic jams. This stadium was
That's all that's been talked about here since late Sunday afternoon when the Braves finished up that victory over the Cubs. Here's the 1-2, and a breaking ball misses low and inside. Want to send along happy 55th anniversary wishes to Mr. and Mrs. Robert Johnson. Robert, the former head groundskeeper for the Braves here at Atlanta Fulton County Stadium. We still see him out here from time to time, pitching in. Happy anniversary to the Johnsons. Full count 3-2 now on Berryhill.
That was not a good breaking ball from Brantley, but the one before it was a pretty good one down and into Damon, and he's begun to take that pitch. That was one he was swinging at earlier in the month, and it was giving him some trouble. He's more patient. He's waiting to see the ball a little better, and it's resulted in more hits for him.
He took it again, ball four. First walk issued by Brantley. And now Rafael Belliard with his first at bat in a long time. He hasn't played since back on the 18th of August. On the air, Belliard's only been up 44 times, hitting .227, a couple of doubles. He bats here with one out, a runner at first, and we've told you over and over again how much he likes that first pitch. If it's in there, he's going to be hacking at it. Didn't get the fastball, 0-1.
Rafi's only at bat in the month of August came on that appearance on August 18th, so he's 0 for August, but
well,
only
if he
one
get
at
a,
bat.
If he can get a base hit here, a .500 batting average for the month.
I'd take that.
And a balk has been called against Brantley. That'll get Barry Hill down to second.
Brantley, disgusted, fired the rosin bag out towards second. Then he fired it down on the mound. Like Gary Darling called it, not behind him at second base. He started up with that bare hand toward the glove and then stopped.
One little movement.
Mm-hmm.
Foul back the count 0-2 on Rafael Belliard.
Good hack. Rafi didn't go up there looking to take a pitch or two, did he?
Never does. He didn't mean to there and winds up fouling it off. Still 0-2. I think Mr. Brantley may have wanted to send a little message with that pitch. He's a little disgusted, as are all of the Giants, with the way they've performed against the Braves these last four games.
Yeah, you said that Rafi didn't mean to swing. I'm not so sure that Brantley didn't mean to throw it there.
I think he did. 0-2. And Belliard staying alive, 0-2. A lot of Braves fans out there watching tonight may be interested in the Braves baseball heaven down in West Palm Beach, second week in February. It's a fantasy camp type of thing, a lot of fun for everybody. If you'd like more information, and you must be 30 years or older, call 1-800-8-BRAVES, 1-800-8-BRAVES, and they'll send you all the literature on the Braves baseball heaven. On the ground is short, Clayton. Over to first for out number two. And now Greg Maddux should get a nice hand from this sellout crowd. He has turned in another stellar performance tonight. Standing ovation for Greg Maddux.
He gave up one run to the best hitting ball club in the National League in his last start. He's given up two runs to them tonight and only five hits.
And don't forget his slide into second base back in the sixth inning to break up a double play. Nothing in one. It's 0-2 on Maddux. Two strikes on the Braves pitcher with two outs, a runner at second here in the bottom half of the eighth inning. Braves with five runs in the fourth inning, three runs in the eighth inning. David Justice has had the big bat tonight, a two-run single and a two-run homer. Four RBIs for Justice. Two RBIs tonight for Lemke, one each for McGriff and Barry Hill. And Maddux went around, strike three. That takes care of Atlanta here in the bottom half of the eighth inning. We go to the ninth. Braves need three more outs to cut the Giants' margin to 3.5 games. Here we go in the ninth inning, 8-2 Atlanta. Barry Bonds leads off the ninth. It seems like every year the Braves are in a race like this, and they have been for the last 3 years. The fans have picked out one player on the team that they're trying to catch or beat, who has been the player they love to hate, and Barry Bonds, the guy this year for the Giants. It was Darryl Strawberry 2 years ago with the Dodgers. That's a called strike, 0-1. Chris Sabo was the guy with the Reds last year who drew the most response from Braves fans, and of course the past two postseasons, and now in a regular season this year, Barry Bonds. 1-1.
It's funny though, they don't pick on those utility guys hitting 210, do they?
Nope. Barry Bonds 4-for-4. He has done all he can do tonight for his team. Offensively and defensively, as four of the six Giants hits.
Hey, get them all tonight as far as Braves are concerned. They've got enough of a cushion right now that maybe it won't matter. Four hits, he's led off three times, and that's a big key.
Now Todd Benzinger, 0-for-3. That leadoff single will start up the Braves bullpen, Greg McMichael. But Greg Maddux is not one to look over his shoulder for help. He wants these three outs in the ninth inning himself. There's a strike to Benzinger, 0-1. 8-2 Atlanta, we're in the ninth. There goes the runner, and there's a line drive foul. It's nothing in two.
If Maddux can finish this ball game, it would give him seven complete games this year and tie him with Dwight Gooden for the league high. Gooden has seven.
And he had to leave the game tonight with the New York Mets. His shoulder stiffened up in the fourth inning.
Maddux has already reclaimed the lead in innings pitched. He's climbed over Jose Rijo.
Runner again going there, giving Barry Bonds the base if he wants it. Ron Gant calls for this one. One man out in the ninth inning. And that'll bring up Royce Clayton. Clayton 0-for-3 with a couple of ground outs and a fly to center. The shallow center field. Here comes Nixon. There's out number two. Two gone in the ninth, and now this crowd on its feet wanting to see Greg Maddux finish the job. The batter will be Kurt Manwaring. The last time the Braves were as close as 3.5 games to the San Francisco Giants, all the way back on the 19th of May, when Tom Glavin shut out Montreal 1-0. One more out, and the Braves are 3.5 out on August 31st.
And remember, the Braves, 10 games back as late as July 22nd.
Ball one to Manwaring. Look down in the crowd, you're already seeing brooms. This is only game one, folks.
That may give you some indication as to the whereabouts of those fans.
Little ground ball. Terry Pendleton cuts it off to second, and the Atlanta Braves are 3.5 behind the San Francisco Giants as they win the opening game of this series by a final score of 8-2.
Well, the Atlanta Braves cut the lead down to 3.5 games. That's their fourth straight win over the Giants as they take the first game here in Atlanta. And it got started in fine fashion for Atlanta, actually in the top of the third inning with a defensive play, a gem by David Justice with two outs on a broken bat flare by Matt Williams. He dives and makes a catch to save a run. And then at the plate, he does it also. After getting up off the deck, he got low bridged by Dave Righetti. And then he hit one to the bridge and took a look at Dave Righetti as he went into his trot. But to his credit, David Justice actually was running it out. He didn't stand there and stare at it. He trotted around the sacks for his 35th homer of the year. He had four ribbies tonight to give him 96 on the season, and he is our armor all protectant player of the game. Totals in the ball game for the Braves: 8 runs, 9 hits, no errors, and 4 men left on. Giants: 2 runs, 6 hits, an error, and 6 left. Greg Maddux the winner. He's 16-9. He's won 9 of his last 10 decisions. Billy Swift took it on the chin again. He went only 4 2/3 innings. He falls to 17-7. Time of the game, 2 hours and 29 minutes. 33rd sellout of the year, and everybody loved it here in Atlanta, 46,493.
So here's the way it looks going into tomorrow night's game 2 in this series. The Giants up by 3.5 games overall, 4 games up now in the loss column. In game 2 tomorrow night, John Smoltz goes against Brian Hickerson. That'll be on Sports South with Ernie Johnson Sr. and Jr. bringing it your way beginning at 7:30. We're back with you on Thursday night, the final game of this series, Steve Avery against John Burkett, 7:35 Eastern Time on Thursday night. Coming up next on TBS, The Train Robbers, starring Ann Margaret and John Wayne. Stay tuned for that. Until Thursday, for Joe Simpson, Skip Carey, Don Sutton, our entire TBS crew, Pete Van Wieren from the stadium, with a final in game 1 of this series, the Braves 8 and the Giants 2. The Braves now 3.5 games back in the West. Good night, everyone.